Hey everyone, in our last video, we talked a bit about what Lagrange polynomials are, and how we can use them to interpolate data. In this video, we're going to go through a third-order Lagrange polynomial interpolation example so that you can see how we solve one of these problems. We are asked to estimate for the output of the following data set using Lagrange polynomial interpolation for an input of x equals 3. I'm going to take a second now and write out the general formula for any order Lagrange polynomial here. If you have seen our previous video on Lagrange polynomials, since we have four data points presented here, we are going to have four terms in our Lagrange polynomial, and we are going to have 4 minus 1 degree of the Lagrange polynomial, and therefore a third degree Lagrange polynomial. Now, let's talk about how we solve this problem. We will first begin by using the formula above to develop our general third-order Lagrange polynomial equation. Then, we will plug in our known discrete data points, simplify our polynomial, and then lastly, once we have the Lagrange polynomial developed, we can plug in the input we are asked for and finally solve for our output. Our first step is to develop our third-order Lagrange polynomial equation. In brief, we know that we will need one term for each data point we need our polynomial to pass through. So, I will just go ahead now and write out the general third-order Lagrange polynomial equation. If you are at all confused on how I am developing this third-order general equation, check out our Introduction to Lagrange Polynomial video in the description down below. Now that we have that written all out, we have completed our first step in the solution. We must now plug in our data points and simplify, such that the Lagrange polynomial is fit to our specific problem. Since we have quite a large number of calculations, I'm just going to go ahead and write out our full solution to this, and we will return with our solution. As you can see, after grouping our common terms, we're left with a final interpolation function of 0.25x cubed minus 1.5833x squared plus 5x plus 0.33. Now, if you want to actually do a quick check by plugging our x terms into our Lagrange polynomial, remember that when we are interpolating our function, it needs to pass through all of our given data points. Therefore, by plugging in our x terms, we need to get our y terms back. If we do not, that means that we made a mistake at some point in our calculations. I will just go ahead and complete that now. As you can see, we are returned our outputs as expected. Lastly, we just need to plug in our input of 3 into our newly found Lagrange interpolation function, and we receive an output of 7.833, which is the solution to the question that we were asked. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a third-order Lagrange polynomial. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.